Hello, this is a tutorial for the Cure Lullaby. Being hammered with emails for a tutorial for this one, more so than most of the other videos at the moment, so better do one, eh? It's a nice one to play. It is a bit tricky to get the hang of, but sort of once it falls into place, then it's okay. But it's actually all based around only a few chords, so it's not as bad as it seems. And I should stress again, this is just purely the way I do it. It's not the way the Cure play it at all, I don't think. But, capo on 4th fret if you want it to be in tune with the album version, but feel free to put it wherever you like, wherever you find it easier. Now, the whole song is basically based around an A minor and F major 7 chords. Basically just goes between those two chords through the whole song, and in the bridge there is a D minor. Okay. Now, A minor and F major 7 both play the 3rd string on the 2nd fret, and you're going to be pretty much just doing little releases on and off that 3rd string. That's the sort of the key for this song. So the A minor, you're going to be going in between effectively then an A minor and an A minor 7. Right? And then same on the F major 7. In fact, you'll probably just be playing, well, in the bit where you're playing that little riff, you're going to be playing the 3 strings here. On the 4th string, the 3rd fret, 3rd string, the 2nd fret, and the 2nd string, the 1st fret. And you're going to be pinkying onto the 3rd fret, 2nd string to make that riff. So the little riff actually just goes. Straightforward, but you've got to kind of interweave that into the strum of the A minor and the F major 7. So I'll just do it slowly for you once. Fairly slowly for you. So, A minor, and you're going to be just on the bass, you're going to hit that A string pretty much each time. Release the 3rd. Then move to the F major 7 formation, but pinky goes straight onto the 2nd string 3rd fret. Plucks it twice, then pluck the open E, then the 3rd string. Another strum, release your pinky, and then back on again. Back to the 3rd, then release the 3rd. Alright, so. That's the hardest part. If you remember, when you go to the F major 7 chord, pinky goes straight on. Okay? You got plenty of time to release the pinky because you're going to play the 1st and then the 3rd before you come back to the 2nd string again. And then just sort of strum. As you're strumming down, you're going to stop more or less and pluck the note that you would at that particular moment. So I know it's hard to understand, but just kind of use your ear and you can pick it up. Doesn't matter if you don't hit exactly the right notes, if you, it will sort of, you'll still be able to hear it through there. Sort of kicks in and you start your singing, don't worry about doing the little run, just play your A minors and your F major 7s, but doing release hammer-ons on the 3rd string. So on candy striped legs, four finger F major 7 here, just during the parts where you don't have to do that little run, because you don't have to, your pinky can stay up here then, instead of having to do that little hammer on down there. Right, so that's the sort of intro verse kind of bit. There's just a little middle eight, bridgey bit, whatever you want to call it, where you go to a D minor. And I feel like I'm being eaten by a thousand million shivering furry holes. So you're just going to go between the D minor and the F major 7. And again, if you like, just releasing on the third string. And I feel like I'm being eaten by a thousand million shivering furry holes. And I know that in the morning I will wake up in the shivering cold. The Spider-Man is always hungry. That's all there is to the song. It does take a little while before you start hitting the right notes, but if you keep at it, like anything, you do eventually pick it up. So yeah, top song. They usually are. The simplest songs are usually the best. Anyway, hope you can pick it up pretty quickly.